Today we are going to cover Briganza House in Goa. It's a very old house having great Goan heritage to it, and the architecture over here that has been used has deep connections to the late Portuguese architectural style and interior style. So they have used a lot of great elements, and some of the actual ornaments that have been used, furnitures that have been used, are originals from almost 1950s, some of them from 1800s, and these have actually been imported from Germany, from Belgium, from Macau, the places which were at the peak of their, at the time when they were at the peak of their, you know, architectural fame and interior fame during those eras. So let's have a look. Okay, so starting from here, we have the classic coat hangers over here. Again, a very must for every household during that time. So you can have your coats, you can have your hats, as well as you can have space for your sticks, for your umbrellas. Very practical during those times, as Goa was, you know, hot and humid and rainy as in most of the times. Again, we have a very signature furniture piece. Not a lot of people talk about this kind of a design. It used to be used earlier. And this is what people call a love seat, and sometimes even a conversational seater, in which two people can sit and face each other and have a conversation, as well as, you know, maybe talk to the other people on the side of the room. This is done in somewhat simplistic style, but as you can see, the wood and the designs over here are really intricate, and a lot of workmanship has gone into this. So the furniture is made of rosewood. As you can see, the designs are very intricately done, and the polish has also been done in a very nice way so that it sustains for such a long period of time. We guys generally have sofas, but some kind of a concept furniture piece like this, which can actually add, you know, more character and more value to your conversations, is a must. So next we're going to talk about the flooring. These are Italian tiles that has been used. As you can see, they have, it's a great pattern that they've used. So these ones are a little tough to you actually assemble and to make. That's why they are premium quality tiles, most of these. And they actually add a huge amount of character to the entire room. A lot of the character that comes from the room comes from the floor, as well as the roof, which has a great wooden pattern to it, almost of a boat-like structure. And you can see the walls are a great color, but they have been subdued a bit. A lot of the character from the walls actually come from the ornaments, the paintings, as well as the really beautiful from the glass chandeliers and lanterns over here. They are actual crystals that have been imported from Belgium, and they are still in great condition. That speaks of the actual quality of workmanship and the quality of the material that has been used, so that they are able to sustain their glamour, their looks, over such a long period of time, even after a lot of renovations, because when these were installed into the house, it was meant actually for candlelights and not for electricity. But now they have been remodeled for that as well, and they still maintain a lot of their looks, a lot of their character. So they add a lot of depth to the entire room. Exquisite crystal artworks, the great paintings, and even the plates that have been used there from Morocco. So having these kind of interior decor pieces really adds a character to it. And over here also we have these amazing tiles. These have been painted tiles over here, again to add character to this area. The Italian top over here, as you can see, they have done a good amount of beveling, a great amount of design to it. The stone in itself is a very rich material. It adds a great amount of character. And the beveling also, it used to be done earlier. Nowadays, you don't see this kind of a beveling happening for countertops. They're actually pretty good because they help with spillage and a lot of other stuff. And, you know, these kind of designs can actually, so these kind of things also help in creating a lot of different patterns and character in your tabletops. And you can see that all the furnitures, they are custom made. They actually have the initials of the family engraved over there. These were custom made for this, for the family. This is a proud testimonial to their lineage, of the rich background that their family has. With every generation, a lot of the stuff have been added, but they've still maintained a lot of their antique pieces, antique masterful pieces of furniture. And having the initials engraved is also something that we guys don't pay attention to that a lot. Something which I think high-end interior designers can actually incorporate very well in their furnitures. So again, these are the chandeliers over here, adding great character. What I would like to emphasize more on is actually the flooring. Again, Italian mosaic flooring, giving a lot of character to the entire room. As you can see, the roof is also done in wood. We have a very exquisite masterpiece of woodwork over here. We have a table in which we have a monkey eating a grapefruit. This is a very old piece of furniture made in 1600s. So the quality of the workmanship and the quality of the material that has been used really comes out because of the life that it has actually sustained, and it has been able to attain such kind of a grandeur even till date. You can also see a good amount of engraving at the back of it. Something which a lot of furnitures, especially in foyer and in other places, they don't use it now. They try to keep it a bit too modern. A lot of intricacies have been used in all the parts of the table. The legs, the back, even the molds over here. And if you pay attention to it, no design has been completely just copied. Like the border and the bottom has not been just copied on the top. So that's again a testament to the furniture maker over here and a design that has gone into it. Next we have this amazing piece of furniture in which one person can easily relax and they can actually keep their feet on the sides. Earlier actually used to make sure that they were able to travel well as have their storages in a place, in a setting in the lobby or in a living space area, where it would actually add to the decor. So people in the earlier times used to pack up their traveling material in the trunks, and they could be lifted and then taken away and then placed back once they return. Again, these kind of things really add character, and this is a testament as to how people actually used to make it more practical traveling as well as use those travel luggages as a part of the home decor. When you come in like this is adding great amount of character. You come in and you immediately leads you to have more homely, more earthy vibe to it. And then you have dining table. There's also a great piece of furniture over here, which can be removed from this in between so that if you have less people, it can be combined in. Over here we have the antique beer mugs. Now this is something like people who like beer would really want to have, I think. So these are the ancient German cups, which were actually, they are copper inside and they are wooden on the outside to make sure that the beer does not get warm. As you can see, they have been very intricately made and the entire inside is actually of copper. So this is how the beer used was supposed to be drunk, and yeah, like I can miss that style. Yeah, so now we are going to enter the ballroom. An amazing concept that I think like a lot of we guys as Indians should maybe have more in our houses. We generally have a dining room, which is like, yeah, it does not give, that does it any justice. I look at this ballroom, like, come on. So these are the signature pieces of the Briganza House over here. These were gifted to the family at the last Portuguese king, which was King Louis. They are again masterpieces of furniture. As you can see, these seats actually had a place for the crest, in which the family's emblem can go. So, as you can see, major highlight of this place is the roof and the painting over there. So all these moldings, as well as the moldings right above the chandelier. All these add a character, a depth to the entire room. It is a very royal and a luxury feel to it. The zinc plating on the roof was done to make sure that it remains, the room remains more cooler as compared to the most of the other rooms because Goa having a hot weather. This makes it relatively very easier to roam around, to have, you can have dances, you can have their ballroom dances, and you can still not feel too hot. As you can see, there are low hanging chandeliers so that one can actually appreciate the designs that go into it. That is also a thing that I think people should incorporate in their designs a bit more. Like having a chandelier just on the, you know, way high, it's beautiful, but one really cannot appreciate the detail that has went into it. This was a design that was used in those times to make sure that the illumination was at its maximum, done in a great way. Over here, the painting of the walls has been done to give a marble effect, which also adds a very soothing touch to it, as well as it adds a grandeur to the room. The flooring is also Italian, it's Italian marble, again to make sure that the cooling factor remains in place. The furniture is again rosewood, all in 1600s, very well maintained. The etching and the painting on it, again the brown and the golden. As you can see, most of the other living room furniture did not have the gold in it. This is the place where you want to accentuate to the society or the public that you'll be inviting in. So again, the gold in it really gives more character, gives a more up-class and a luxury feel to it. Something which you would see was not in the living room or in the more private area of the house. Because this is a place where you'll be entertaining guests. You want to show a little more class over here. Also the mirror. Hey, what happened to using big mirrors in living rooms, in ballrooms? They really add a space to any place. And mirrors are a way in which you can actually, you know, do a lot of artwork in mirrors, and they can also help you add a good grandeur and a luxury feel to a room, specifically if you'll be using chandeliers like this. And again, it's not just the mirror, but the molding of the mirror. People can do a lot of things with it. This is an old mirror, so it actually gives a very kind of ancient antique mirror vibe to it. Goes very well with the right now decor that we are in, the great antique piano. So this is by the S. Rosen Company, imported and agents of Bombay. So this was a very antique piano in which the actual keys of the piano had ivory on it. It's not operational now, you know, for any antique person to come over here in interior and decor. So all the glasses are from Belgium, as I mentioned, the chandeliers, the crystals, as well as the stained glass over here has been done. Great work. So another great aspect of this entire interior is the arches and the big doors that they've added, not just for the entering to the lobby, but also to the balcony. They add great light, great air, as well as the arches have been done in a magnificent molding manner. They're not too edgy, so they are somewhat soft, and they actually lead you to believe that it's a cozy, it's a comfy environment. But the molding and the color combinations that they've used still indicates that it's luxurious, it's upper class, and the attention to detail has been kept in mind while they were doing this. Also the door over here, so these are also made by rosewood. Again, the amount of carving that has gone into it, the glass that has went over here. So these are the details that generally a lot of people don't do nowadays. They try to keep it a bit too modern. This is something over here that you can still have moldings into the door and, you know, not make it too heavy. You're able to make it still somewhat light, and you're able to still give a somewhat grandiose effect of it. Great. So now we're in the guest room, and so they have a single bed over here right now. All the molding that have gone into it, they are somewhat separate pieces. They've come together well. This is how they traditionally used to make it. Also, most of the other pieces of artwork over here, furniture, they are actually made of rosewood only, but they have etchings of mother of pearl over here. These are the actual mother of pearl.
a dip done.
And this used to be something people used to use before they had wardrobes. I find it really practical. So there's actually a furniture piece that takes up all your wardrobe requirements over here. So the part over here is for the coats. Then we have your shirts, your trousers, which can go onto these rods over here. And finally for your shoes. Shoes can be kept over here. Over here you have your hats. So mostly a lot of the accessories that a person uses can actually be accommodated in a really nice way. Specifically for the hats, people don't give any decent space for hats. That's why the hats get crushed all the time. And the fact that they have good amount for shirts, they have trousers, they have coats, which are available in a decent way. So I think somebody needs to come up with, you know, maybe a little modern version of, I might work on that. Yes. This is our first heritage interior video of any place. Hope you guys find this entire video educational and you learned some great deal about the Portuguese interiors as well as the Goan interior that was in here. And you guys can visit this place. We'll let you know the information in our description regarding where you can find this, how you can visit this. And yeah, an amazing place to visit. Do like and share the video and share it with people who are interested in interiors and might need this kind of an interior help. So yeah. Great. Thank you.